Hey there, and welcome to another episode of Sonic Odyssey, the music channel dedicated to bringing you a variety of music from over the last 5 decades or so. And today is going to be one of those really different ones, so I hope you'll enjoy it. But before we dive into the music, there are a few things that you could consider doing, such as liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and sharing the video through your, social applications, so other people can also enjoy the Sonic Odyssey experience. And if you're so inclined, you could feel free to visit our Patreon page, the link for which is in the show description below. That way you can help donate to the channel. It's a system by which you select a tier that you want to donate, and each month you can donate a certain amount of money to the channel to keep the channel going and to help fund the continuing improvements and betterment of the channel. So hopefully you'll consider giving the Patreon page a view, and we do greatly appreciate your patronage. Today we're going to be looking at an album which is rather unique. I struggle to find the exact best way to describe it because it is such a unique mix of music. It is jazz piano, and it is a duet of jazz piano. And if that has not given you a clue as to the musicians involved, we are talking about Chick Corea and Hiromi Uehara. And this particular pairing came together in 2006, I believe it was. I want to make sure I get the dates correct. They did this in 2006 and released it, I think, in 2008. I'd have to check the dates to be sure. Yes, it was released in 2008. I don't mind going to my notes on this one because this one is really a special treat and requires accuracy more than my continued eye contact with the lens. Chick Corea has been making jazz music in a variety of forms. He's primarily a pianist, but he's also a keyboardist, synthesizerist, you name it. He is a master of the keyboards, and he's been doing that since the 1960s. He's been producing albums for Blue Note and GRP and all of the record labels that you could imagine, Warner Brothers, you name it, he's been on the label. He's an extraordinary talent who has a tremendous gift for the classical as well as the traditional and all forms of jazz. It doesn't matter if it's bebop or fusion. He can transition between them seamlessly. And Hiromi Uehara is a young lady from Japan. She is quite the junior to Mr. Corea. She has been making albums since I think she was 19 years old. She's also a piano prodigy, and Chick Corea actually met Hiromi when he was in Japan in I think it was 2000s, in the early 2000s, when she was only 17 years old, and they hit it off very well. They played together a little bit, and then in 2006 the opportunity came together for them to have this duet, just two grand pianos on a stage, no other instrumentation, and played live in the Blue Note in Tokyo. I should make a note. I personally do not want to generally discuss live recordings. I feel that live recordings tend to be nothing more than glorified greatest hits albums with, you know, flourishes and flares of some newness to them, but they tend to still be, you know, greatest hits compilations and not representative of a musician or a band at a particular stage in their career. But this is a very different situation. This is two musicians coming together, playing a variety of songs, of which we will get into after the musical teaser that I'll play for you in just a few moments. They aren't really, it's not as though these songs existed for these musicians in another format. If it weren't for the fact that the Blue Note Club and the people involved were able to record this particular three-night set of recordings, they wouldn't exist, and we wouldn't have the pleasure of their existence. So I am making a little bit of a deviation from my normal feeling about live albums to incorporate this one. When I began Sonic Odyssey, this was probably my third or fourth choice of album that I knew I had to cover. It's been an album that's been with me since 2008, and I've gone back to it numerous times. I find it both comforting, relaxing, and exhilarating. So I knew that this would be something that I wanted to expose to more people, because I don't think the album got nearly enough attention when it was released, and nor has it really seen much light of day. It's in fact really hard to find on the iTunes store if you want to buy it digitally. By the way, if you do want to find it on the iTunes store, look for Chick and Hiromi, and that's the only way you're going to find it. If you look for Hiromi Uehara, or if you look for Chick Corea, you're not going to find it under them. It is under Chick and Hiromi, with the ampersand. So look for that there, and hopefully you'll enjoy it as much as I do. So before we go any further in discussing this musical odyssey, let us give a little bit of a listen to a song from John Lennon and Paul McCartney, Fool on the Hill. Chose the song Fool on the Hill because I feel that it represents a song that people might already be familiar with through the, you know, writings of Lennon and McCartney, and also because it showcases their playing off one another in playful and jubilant ways in the course of the song. I hope the teaser gave you a good sense of what these two pianists bring to the table. The pianist to the left channel would be Chick Corea, and I believe Hiromi is to the right. Which should probably on camera be opposite. the song The Fool on the Hill has a very mellow pacing. It does pick up and gallop along a little bit, but it is a very simple and yet at the same time extremely delicate and wonderful bit of piano arrangement for duet. I hope that you enjoyed that snippet. To give you a hint of what else you could possibly expect, I'm going to read the titles of the songs and the authors of the songs, and you'll have to forgive me if I butcher any of the names, because some of them are quite, well, foreign to my tongue. The first CD begins with track number one, entitled Very Early, by Bill Evans. Track two, How Insensitive, by Antonio Carlos Jobim and Vinicius de Moraes. And track number three is Deja Vu by Hiromi. Track number four, Fool on the Hill by Lennon McCartney. Track number five, Humpty Dumpty by Chick Corea. Track number six, Boulevard Blues by Thelonious Monk. Track number one on CD two is Windows by Chick Corea. Track number two is Old Castle by the River in the Middle of a Forest by Hiromi. Track three is Summertime by George Gershwin, Irwin Gershwin, and Dubose Hayward. Track number four is Place to Be by Hiromi. Track number five is Domo, Children's Song number 12 by Chick Corea. And track number six, Concierto de Aranjuez, Spain, by Joaquin Vedre Rodrigo and Chick Corea. So those are the 12 tracks that come in this 2-CD compilation, and it is phenomenal. They're two talents that have such incredibly gifted abilities, and yet also present their playing styles in their own unique way. I would say that Hiromi is more airy, more flighty, a little bit more wispy, and yet she can be very strong and powerful in her performance as well. But she has this lightness to her performance that for me is wonderful. I own, I think, 9 of her albums, and can't say that I don't like any one of them. The earlier albums from Hiromi tended to be a little bit more electronic. She used a lot more keyboards and synthesizers in her music, but her last 4 or 5 albums have been much, much more traditional, just jazz piano, and really marvelous for that. Chick Corea, again, if you're not familiar with him, that's hard to believe. He's been around for so long and touched so many bands and so many forms of music and informed so much music over his 5 decades in the music business. He is powerful, and yet he has the capacity for great tenderness and simplicity when it's noted. He plays a very touching style of piano. They're both, I think that of the two, Chick Corea may be the slightly more emotional player, but that might just be due to his many more decades of playing than Hiromi. Hiromi is not at all machine-like, not at all in any way machine-like, but she does have not quite the same emotionality in at least this two CD set duet. But she does have tremendous flair and style and a gift that just is needed to be heard to be believed. Hiromi has a much more flighty style, much more whimsical and airy style to her playing. And I think that about wraps it up for what I have to say about Duet. It is a one-of-a-kind, once-in-a-lifetime treat. Any jazz piano fan really should look into it, and even if you're into other forms of music, it's still just breathtakingly beautiful to listen to this piano duet. I highly recommend it, and I do give it a 5 out of 5. I hope that you will consider giving it a listen and adding it to your musical library. It's very well worth it. So thank you very much for watching, and please remember to subscribe so you can stay up to date on all things Sonic Odyssey. And please be kind enough to visit our Patreon page so you can see if there's a tier there that suits your economic situation and can help donate to the channel and keep the channel growing and continuing to bring out more musical videos like this. I know that much of the music that I've covered so far has been really diverse. This is probably the most out there that people might have expected from the channel so far, but I think it's beautiful, and I hope that you will too. So have a great day, and see you next time. Bye.